keep your distance. Check your mirror, how close is the guy behind you?
Teenage drivers are 4 times more likely to be involved in a fatal crash than drivers in their 30s.
Trying to do things that a car isn't capable of doing, going around a corner too fast, they don't want to slow down.
According to the latest statistics, about 6,000 young people are killed each year in fatal crashes involving teenage drivers, and many of these crashes involve alcohol.
Adolescents are a very reckless sort of group in some ways. They really feel that they're invulnerable.
So why do you need driver's license?
Research shows that driver education classes are not the answer. Students in those classes have the same crash experience as those who are not. What has been shown to be more effective is changing the laws surrounding some of the problem areas of teenage driving. Night curfews that prevent teens from driving when half their fatal crashes occur. Lowering blood alcohol limits and raising drinking ages, since alcohol evolved in almost 30% of teen fatalities. And finally, requiring students to learn to drive and gain experience through graduated licensing.
I mean, it makes sense to phase people in gradually to full driving privileges. It reduces injuries to them. It reduces injuries to other people that they encounter on the roads.
And since attitude will likely remain a problem with teenage drivers, parents can take immediate steps to encourage young drivers to drive larger cars with more safety features and to always buckle up. Carolyn Gorman reporting.